hopes of an early end to Melbourne's lockdown have been dashed despite another day of low COVID case numbers.
It comes as our jab rollout reaches a new milestone with 5 million doses now administered. Strategic health consultant Professor Bill Bertel joins us now in the studio. Bill, good morning to you. We learned this morning that Victoria will also be getting an extra 100,000 Pfizer doses. Where do we pluck those from?
Well, that's a very good question, Carl. We wouldn't know because the federal government just refuses to say how many vaccine doses are in Australia, where they are in the distribution network, how many do they expect to deliver and into an arm in each state by the end of this week, next month and so on. So the numbers change all the time. It's very good, of course, that the vaccines are going to Victoria. That's very important, and obviously what's happened there is really got people interested in being vaccinated, so that's a great thing. But really, the federal government's policy on this is really all over the place. Today in Australia, 2.2% of Australians are fully vaccinated. That's half the number in Equatorial Guinea. In the equivalent number in the United Kingdom, 40% are fully vaccinated today. So we've just got to get on top of this vaccination rollout effort. We've got to set targets. The federal government's got to be open and transparent about how many vaccine doses are in the country, on order, and will be delivered around Australia by certain dates.
And is there an additional sense of urgency here because we've now got this Delta variant, which was from India, circulating within the community?
Yes, well, Professor Lewin, the head of the Doherty Institute, said on the weekend that she was very concerned about the Delta variant. There are unlinked cases in Victoria. They can't find the connection between the fellow who came from Adelaide and the problems they've had this week. So the Delta variant is there. And we've got to ask, how is this getting into the country? Is it coming out of hotel quarantine? We know that that's a very leaky system. There have been over 20 leakages from hotel quarantine in the last several months. Or is it coming from people who are being exempted by the federal government from having to quarantine, from having to take tests if they come in private jets or if they're in an exempt category?
How many people are given exemption?
It's a really good question, Carl. We don't know the answer to that. We know that at the end of last year, when we had the Northern Beaches outbreak in New South Wales, there was quite a high supposition that that had come from flight crews who were exempted and who were coming and going. And quite properly, that was cracked down on. But how many people are being exempted from COVID testing and quarantine this week in Australia? These are given out by the federal government, and as far as I can see, those numbers are not being published every day, and they should be.
So just explain that. So you're saying some people are coming into this country, they don't even have to do 2 weeks quarantine at home. They're allowed to just circulate within the community as soon as they come in, and they're not being forced to have COVID tests?
Well, it seems to be so. The exempt categories are there. There are diplomats and other VIPs who seem to be coming and going from the country with exemptions from quarantine and from testing. Now, what are the rules? Who is being exempted? Particularly, how many people are being exempted? Because we have this Delta virus variant, which is more infectious and a lot of trouble. It's even causing trouble in the United Kingdom, where so many people are vaccinated already, but their numbers of daily cases are going up despite the vaccines and because of this Delta variant. We don't want that here.
There were calls for the lockdown to end prematurely. That's unlikely to happen now. What do you think the week holds in Victoria?
It seems that they're getting on top of it. Their contact testing and tracing seems to be working really well, which is great, and the daily numbers are going in the right direction. But as the acting Premier said, they've just got to clobber it. We've got to get back to that zero COVID and keep and maintain that. We saw a year ago how quickly it went from a handful of cases and then just expanded exponentially. Mm. And let's remember, though, the cost of the lockdown in Melbourne is really considerable, not just on people's mental health but in the economy, that the costs that are incurred by these lockdowns, which come from not running a proper vaccination and quarantine program, are huge. And the cost of getting it right is just the merest fraction of what it's costing in Victoria this week and next week. So let's hope they get on top of it straight away and we can get back to normal business in Victoria.
Do you think there is a chance the lockdown could extend past Thursday?
Well, that will be in the hands of the medical advisers to the Victorian government. I'm sure that they want to get out of a lockdown as soon as possible, but you can't do it prematurely. The worst thing we could have is like a yo-yo situation. You almost get on top of it, you dispense with the lockdown, and then before you know it, you've got to go back into it again. We don't want that.
OK, there's the talk of another Commonwealth-built quarantine hub. Do you think that's going to happen anywhere else apart from Victoria and Howard Springs?
Well, I think it's imperative that we have a proper quality quarantine in all of the major ports in Australia, so Sydney, Brisbane, Perth, Adelaide, as well as regional centres if we have to do that, so that we have a Howard Springs type facility constructed in each of those cities, near the airport, near the hospital services that are required, and importantly, near the quality staff we need to do these things at scale. So the sooner that's done, the better. It's a big step in the right direction. I think it'd be very important, though, that these quality quarantine facilities replace hotel quarantine. Yeah. Mm-hmm. At the moment, it seems to be that they want to add to the capacity of hotel quarantine, and it's pretty clear. Now, we've had over 20 breaches of hotel quarantine in the last several months, one every 11 days. So I don't think hotel quarantine any longer should fit in the way that we're going to run quarantine in Australia.
All right, Bill. Good to talk to you this morning. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.